Hi, I'm Dimitris, and in this video series, I'll show you how to create a complete network starting from zero with all the necessary data to undertake a microscopic simulation of the network. So basically, we will see how to import an OpenStreetMap decoration, background images, how to define and control plan, a public transportation, and the traffic demand data to feed our simulation. So let's first start the Aimsun Next software. By double-clicking on the shortcut, I will open the Aimsun Next software. I will head to Tutorials, and from the drop-down menu, I will select the tutorial, which is called Editing. On the bottom of the page, you will find the documentation, which is always available, and of course, the initial and the finished network of this exercise. The first step after starting the Aimsun Next is to create a new model. This can be done by going on the New Project button here on the UI, or by just going on the File, New, pressing the new project window will pop up, and then I can define the folder where the new project can be stored by placing the three dots. I can change the directory and, of course, the project name, which in my case will be Tutorial Editing. Then the template that I can select, in my case, will be the default one, the Aimsun template. We provide some other different templates for US conditions. And of course, the user is able to create his own template by following the instructions in the manual. Next, on the description box, we can add any information about this project. So for example, this is for. Next, on the options, I can select micro, meso, static macro, or travel demand options to be appeared in the UI of the Aimsun Next software. This means that all the parameters corresponding to the micro, meso, static macro, and travel demand will appear when I double-click on an object or when I right-click on an object. To avoid all these parameters, since I'm not going to use any travel demand modeling in this exercise, nor static macro, nor meso, I will deactivate those options, and I will focus only on the micro simulation parameter options. Next, I need to define the coordinate system so that my network is located correctly. Define the UTM zone, and of course, the rule of the road. We know that some regions, as UK or Australia, the rule of the road is left. Then we have several options by accessing the map window here. Do nothing, which will do nothing actually if I press OK now. Or I can set an area, I can import map from file, or I can import map from the internet. So by selecting this option, I can just zoom in to any area of the world, and if the information is available in the OpenStreetMap database, then this will be downloaded directly and appeared in the Aimsun Next UI. That's a very easy and common, actually, way to create a network from scratch and then start editing. There are various ways to create the geometry of a model in Aimsun Next. We can use either an AutoCAD file or an image as a base, and then on top edit the road network, or we can import the road network directly using the OpenStreetMap, the GIS external sources, or other software. In this tutorial, we will just use the OpenStreetMap to provide a decoration layer and use an aerial orthophoto JPG format to give the geometric detail. So first of all, I'll import the OSM file by going to the menu bar, File, Import, OpenStreetMap Files, and I will head to the installation folder of the Aimsun Next software, where this file is located. So I'll go to this PC, C, Program Files, Aimsun, Aimsun Next 20, Docs, Tutorials, Editing, and I will select the map.osm file. I will open this file. I will not import the roads, but I will import only the decoration. On the 3D tab, I will activate the creation blocks for all buildings, and I will set the average height to be 20 meters with a deviation of 10 meters. Also, I will texturize polygons according to land use, if this information is available in my database of the OpenStreetMap, and I will also create some trees. Then I will press OK. To check that the elevation of the buildings has been created correctly, I will open the 3D view from the view, new 3D view, and another window will open next to the two-dimension window here. So I will select the main camera, and here I can see that my buildings have a height with an average of 20 meters and a deviation of 10 meters. I will close the 3D view by clicking on the view and then pressing the option close. Next step is to import the aerial photo called orthophoto.jpg. I will go again to the menu bar, File, Import, Image File this time, and I will head again on the directory of the Aimsun Next. Program Files, Aimsun, Aimsun Next 20, Docs, Tutorials, Editing, and I will select the orthophoto.jpg file. By opening this file, another pop-up window appears. The import image, the units are meters, and I will leave all these dimensions as predefined. I will press OK. And then here I can see the JPG file, image file, imported. However, the dimensions don't look correct. So in this case, I will first move the image on the side. I will double click on the image. I will go to the positioner option of the tab to reference my image with the correct dimensions imported by the OSM file. So to do that, I need to reference 2 points of the OSM background with the 2 image points. So I will select this point and that point. And then here in my image, I will also select this point and that point. I will press Scale and Translate, and then here I can see that the image has been scaled and moved to the correct position as it should be. I will press OK. I will select the decoration layer, the sublayer images, and I will deactivate the Allow Object Editing option. So now the image underneath will not be edited.